Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you a new plugin for Capture One. Now, if you're a Capture One user and you have struggled to find something that's fast and efficient to be able to deliver your jobs to clients, then maybe this is something you should consider plugging into your workflow. So I'm going to demonstrate how it works very quickly today. There's a lot to get through, so I'm going to try and make it as quick as possible. Let's jump over to my MacBook and I'll show you where we get started. So here we are on my MacBook Air, and this is my sample shoot. So I have 100 images in this session. So let's, for example, this is a shoot, a live shoot in the studio, and this is, say, scenario one, so shot one. And we want to upload it to our profile on Moodcase. So what we're going to do is select all the images. We go to Image, Publish, Publish to Moodcase. Super easy. This is really, really easy. And then we create a new client, Lunar New Year, Beauty Shoot. I have this configured. My recipe configuration is quality 20, resolution 72, scales at 20%. I'm going to go ahead and hit Publish. Just going to go ahead and process those JPEGs like you would do with a normal recipe. And then it's going to push them up to your Moodcase profile. So you've created a new client, and then you've created a new project. So the idea with this is we're live on a shoot, and I want to be able to share this job live with the client. And I want them to start marking up the shots as we get through the day. So by the end of the day, all my assistant or myself has to do is just upload the remaining shots to your profile on Moodcase. And then really it's hand over to the client, and they'll then need to go through the edit, obviously, make their selects, and then let you know when they finish their selects. And I'm going to show you how they do that in a second. So we're still waiting for these to finish processing and uploading. So whilst that's going ahead, I'm going to quickly show you the profile on Moodcase. Because if we jump over here, we will then see our shoot in the Moodcase profile. So you've got your clients down here. So here's a few of my other shoots. And then today's shoot and shot is listed here. So here are all the shots being pushed up to this area on my Moodcase. Now, you're going to probably want to find out quickly how much is it going to cost you. Well, I can tell you it's not going to cost you anything to start a basic profile. You don't even need to put a credit card or any payment details in. We'll go across to the Moodcase website. So on their front page, finally, one place for your clients to select, comment, receive your photos. And then their pricing structure is as follows. So as I said, you can have a free profile, 1 gig of storage. I can get about three days of shooting on that. I think the JPEGs that I've uploaded today are about 0.2 meg. So then you've got your basic 25 gig storage, then 500 gig storage, then 750 gig. So you can scale it according to how often you shoot and how much space you need. So that's Moodcase. That's their website. Oh, with the free profile, I think there's a thing also where if you refer people, you get a few extra gigs of data. I think you can get up to like 5 free gigs of data space. So that works very well. So yeah, so here we are again inside my profile on Moodcase. You go ahead and create your profile on their website. And because this is a web app, you don't have to worry about it working on a Mac or a PC. It's cross-platform, obviously. And then all you need to do is install the plugin for Capture One. So I'm going to quickly show you where you get that. As I said, I'm going to try and get through this as quick as possible because I know you're going to want to download this and get it installed, because I was incredibly excited when I found out about it, because it is a little bit of the answer to all my prayers. I've been looking for something like this for quite a while. Anyway, as you can see here, there's two plugins. I've downloaded the Capture One plugin, obviously, and they also have it for Adobe Lightroom. Now, this is Lightroom Classic. I'm not a user of Lightroom Classic, so I'm not going to go over that today, but I can make that in a future video if you'd be interested. If you are, please drop me a comment below, and I'll be happy to help out on that. And going back to the profile, so now you know how to integrate it with Capture One. It's very easy once you install it. You just then have to log into your profile in the preferences pane. So what we need to do now is share our project with our client. So we're still on the shoot, remember? And I want to share this shot, shot one, with the client. So we go to share project. And the best thing about this is you can customize how you share it with your client. So you can go through all these pull downs and select rate images, label images, comment images, etc., etc., etc. You can go through all this and customize it how you wish. So basically, I want to share the images with the client. I want them to be able to rate them. I want the images to have watermarks on them because I don't want them being pulled off and used anywhere else until the images are finished and retouched. And then I need the clients to be able to do a client selection. We definitely need them to be able to review. Workflow is very handy for them to have also. And then downloading. I'm going to allow them to download the images, but they will have a watermark on them. And you can customize your own watermark to go over the images. Again, it's very easy. It's in the settings here, so I won't go over it now. But and then you create your link. Now, the beauty about this is, and I really like this because it makes it super slick. Excuse me. You can customize a subdomain of your own domain name to go into this link. So you can, well, I've got on here edit.simonsonghurst.com as the first part of the share link. So I think that looks really professional when you're submitting these jobs. So then go ahead and copy that link. Now what I'm going to do is jump across to Safari, another browser, and I'm going to put that into the address bar. And now essentially we are the client. So the shoot's now loading. We're the client now looking at this, and they can go ahead and start rating them. So incidentally, if the client's rated any images, either with stars or colors in the studio, they will get ported across to this profile. So you can either create a shot over here that says client selects, or they'll be able to see them in there already. So now looking at this as the client, they're going to go through and make their final selects. So let's just say they've, these are their final selects. What you'll want to do, or what they'll want to do then, is come down to here, add images to selection, and then finalize selection. And then it will ask for their email address, and you then click finalize, or they'll then click finalize, and it will email me, email you as the photographer, that final selection. So when you go into clients' selections here, you can click on this pull down, click on, hang on 1 second. Oh, I need to go back to my profile, of course. I was as the client. So jumping back across to Google Chrome and back as the photographer. So now inside here, let's refresh this page. If you go to this pull down, sorry, go to the selection, go to my favorites here. So this essentially would be the client selection with the green ticks. And then this works really well for me because this cuts down a lot of time. Click on export and you get the list of file names ready to then copy across to Capture One. If you go to the search box, paste them in, you then get your raw files all collated in one place, ready for you to then send across your retoucher. I really like that. That has cut down a lot of time for me. And what I'd then do is I'd create a profile for the retoucher also on Moodcase, because then I can push EIP files with all my settings on directly into the Moodcase profile. I can then go ahead and mark up the images inside there. And then I can give the retoucher access for them to be able to then push the images back to me when they finish retouching them. And if I need to go ahead and mark them up even more, I can do that all within that one profile. So I think for me, Moodcase is great because it's centralized and you can manage your entire project with many, many different members of your team, right the way through to sort of handover with the client. So I think For me, it's become an essential in my workflow. I've used it the last 3 weeks, and I can tell you I'm probably going to use it on all my shoots from now on. It's something that I've been looking for a long time. I had previously been using Dropbox, Google Drive, and WeTransfer, but I'd never really found any of them to be particularly, fast and efficient for photographers. I didn't like giving the client all the JPEGs over WeTransfer. With Dropbox, sometimes you couldn't share links with certain companies, their servers wouldn't accept it, and similar with Google Drive. But I haven't had any issues with Moodcase, and I'd highly, highly recommend you take a look at this and plug it into your workflow and see how you get on. Also, I'm really curious to find out, how have you been delivering your jobs previously? Have you used Google Drive, Dropbox, or WeTransfer, or anything else that I haven't mentioned? What have you been using? Leave it in the comments below. I'll be curious to find out. Let me know what you think of Moodcase. I've tried to keep this as quick as possible today because there was so much to go over and there's still a lot to cover, but I can do that in other videos if you're interested in me telling you more. The developers would be very interested to hear any comments or any additional ideas of what you might have on this software, this web app. One of the other things that I really like about this is you can create galleries and then you can have portfolio galleries on your iPad. So I like to go out client meetings with my iPad, and it's just easy to then select the icon on the iPad for that particular portfolio. It's all branded, and I think that looks super professional. So that's Moodcase. That's my quick introduction to it today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. Please consider subscribing. I'm going to be making a lot more content now. I've changed up my studio, so I'm ready to create more sort of simplified tutorials for photography and filmmaking and software, and also be doing some gear reviews too. So I thank you for watching today's video, and I hope to see you on the next one. Bye for now.